My name is Gabi Ortiz. I am a second year plant biology student, and I'm hoping to minor in microbiology and biotechnology. First research experience I'm involved in, I'm working as an undergraduate researcher through this program called eScoop.
But basically what I'm doing is I'm working to analyze the microbial communities that exist in this newly developed aerobic treatment system. For my second research project, we're working through this program called the Sustainable Futures Fellows. And through this program, we are working to develop a proposal to expand sustainability in urban cities, and specifically working to increase the amount of native vegetation in these cities. And we're using Raleigh, our very local city here, as a case study to do that. Starting in research just this year, I'm involved in my classes and I'm taking pretty heavy STEM classes right now. When I started my research, it kind of quickly became like, oh my gosh, this is a lot on my plate all of a sudden. And so I really had to work on my time and my skills, be able to plan things out better, because if you start getting too overwhelmed, that can lead to burnout. And that's just not very sustainable, no pun intended. When research is specifically in the lab, it's a pretty steep learning curve. And when you're in there for the first time, you're very lost and you don't know what things are. And just over the course of this past year, I have definitely had to redo things like so many times. So research in general kind of just teaches you that perseverance. You have to keep going. You just get up, you redo things, you try again. My key experiences now, they've taught me a lot in terms of what I am actually like interested in. Like, for example, I came to state really curious about pharmaceuticals. I really wanted to get involved with that. And after being able to hear about the experiences and perspectives of my different mentors and different undergraduate researchers that I'm surrounded by, now I have a big focus in, you know, nutrition and like sustainable agriculture and like plant microbe interactions. And so my interests in research have really shifted, and I think that's really valuable because that just kind of keys up what I'm going to continue to pursue and work on. It's taught me a lot about myself and the role I want to play in research. The biggest difficulty wasn't really in getting involved with research in the first place. I found that the biggest obstacle I faced is just kind of like this imposter syndrome. As I mentioned, like research, being involved in research for the first time, there's a pretty steep learning curve. And, you know, you enter this space and you see all these other undergraduate researchers and you're like, oh my God, everybody knows what they're doing. And when you enter in this space for the first time, you feel very lost and it can be very overwhelming very quickly. So it can become very easy to let this imposter syndrome envelop you and surround you. And once that happens, it can be very easy to start questioning or doubting your own abilities and your own, you know, what you bring to the table. It's always a work in progress, but I've been able to overcome it slightly just by prioritizing breaks for myself and prioritizing that self-care and do that consistently. And that really helps me clear my mind and kind of recenter myself, feel good in myself so I can keep doing the work I'm doing and put the best out there. If you're interested in undergraduate research, keep your head up high. Like, know that you are intelligent. You are worthy of being in this space and research. It's kind of inevitable that you're going to be facing difficult moments. That's, you know, kind of a part of life. Not everything goes to plan. Don't let those bad moments start getting in the way of your own self-confidence, because that will affect everything around you. I would also say get involved with research as early as possible. And so getting started early, just kind of try to expose yourself to all these different opportunities and all these different perspectives and experiences in research so you can learn more about what you want to do. Really reflect on what you want out of a research experience, right? And what you want in it,
So like, what type of mentor do you want? Like, a lot of people think of like, you know, you're in the lab, you're like pipetting, but research is like a lot of different things. It's not just like wet lab work, but it's also like computational research, or there's field research. There's just so much you can do. Definitely don't limit the possibilities or think that research might not be for you because you haven't seen it publicized as that.